Hey everyone, I hope you all are doing well. So the topic for today's learning is nutrition and its types, as you all can see. So before starting the topic, you should know what is nutrition. So nutrition is basically a process by which an organism derives its nutrients from the environment for its growth and development. So the nutrition is categorized into two main categories. So the first one is the autotrophic nutrition and second one is the heterotrophic nutrition, as you all can see. First of all, we are going to discuss about the autotrophic nutrition. So autotrophic nutrition is a type of nutrition in which an organism derives its nutrition or prepares its own food by itself only by using simple substances that it gets from the environment, and the organisms that exhibit this type of nutrition are called as autotrophs. And as you already know, the autotrophs in the whole world is the plant. Moving on to the next one, how the plants are making their own food. So the process called photosynthesis is there by which the plants are making their or preparing their own food. So basically, what is photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is a process by which the plants use carbon dioxide and water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll to make glucose, that is the food of the plant, and in this whole process the energy is being released. The main two thing is the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. Without these two things, the plant cannot prepare their own food. So this is all about the autotrophic nutrition, and the example of autotrophs is the plants. Now moving on to the next part, that is heterotrophic nutrition. So as you already know, heterotrophic nutrition is a process in which the organism depend upon other organism for its food and nutrition. So the example of heterotrophic nutrition or the heterotrophs are animals, some bacteria and fungi, and the organism that exhibit this type of nutrition are called as heterotrophs. In these category, four things are there. First of all, parasitic plants. Second, saprophytes. Third, insectivorous plants. And fourth but not the least, that is symbiotic relationship. We are going to discuss all the three topics in detail right now. So first of all, let's start with the parasitic plants or the parasites. So basically, what are parasites? The organism that depends totally on other living organism for its nutrients are called as the parasite. So the organism that is involved in this process is called a host. जिससे वो अपने nutrients derive कर रहा है, उसको हम लोग host बोलते हैं. The two example of parasitic plants are doodle and mistletoe. And in this parasitic category, we are having two type of parasitic plants. First one is the total parasite and second one is the partial parasite. So what is the difference between these two, that is the total parasite and the partial parasite? So the total parasite is a thing in which the parasite is totally dependent upon host for its food and nutrition. For example, the doodle is there. And coming on to the next one, that is the partial parasite. Partial parasite, it means it is partially dependent upon host for its food. For example, it is preparing its own food, but for water and minerals, it is depending upon the host. So it is not depending fully, it is depending partially on the host for its food and nutrition or whatever it is. So now let's move on to the next one or the next category, that is of insectivorous plants. Insectivorous plant, as you already know, okay, some plants are there which derives its nutrients from insect or by trapping and digesting insect. The common example of insectivorous plants are the sundew plant, the Venus flytrap, the pitcher plant. These plants are having some special scented things or a special nectar like thing, due to which the insects are getting attracted to them as they are being trapped in the structure. After that, the plant is releasing some digestive juices through which the insect is being digested, and the plant can derive its nutrients. Now the third category is of saprophytes. Saprophyte, as you already know, that depends upon dead and decaying matter for their nutrients. They decompose dead plants and animals and derive the nutrients from there. The examples of saprophytes are some bacteria and fungi. Last but not the least, that is the symbiotic plants or the symbiotic relationship. So basically, it is a type of relationship in which two organisms are there which benefits the both. It means if I am giving you something, you are also providing me something. this type of relation is called as the symbiotic relationship, and the organisms that are involved in this type of relationship are called as the symbionte. The examples of symbionte are lichens. Lichen is a close association between an algae and a fungus. Here the algae is an autotroph and the fungus is a saprophyte. So the algae is preparing the food for the fungus, and in return the fungus is providing water and mineral to the algae. Thank you.